1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1.
Is it recording? Oh yeah.
Hey my friends, look what came through the door just now. I open it up and then we'll talk about what it is. So as you guys can tell, I retired my old 34 ultra-wide LG display and bought a new one. Why did I get rid of the old one? Simply because I didn't fall in love with that curved display as much as I thought I would. If you're into gaming or watch movies, having that curved display gives you an extremely immersive experience and it was really just a joy to look at. But if you're a person like me and you're more into productivity and you're editing videos or photos or you're designing, having that curved display was really bothersome, simply because you can't see any straight lines. And if you're designing or if you want to frame your shot properly, it really is difficult. So when I moved, I thought, why carrying that big box? I sold my old display and now that I'm in my new place, I invested in a new one, which is the 4K display from LG, the 32UD99. Why did I go with this one? First of all, it's a 4K, huge, gorgeous looking display, but it has USB-C. So theoretically, you can drive this display with your MacBook Pro using a USB-C cable. And at the same time, the display would be charging your MacBook Pro through that very same cable. Only one cable, it makes for a very easy and clean setup. I say theoretically, because I had some issues with that, and we talk about this in just a second. Another selling point was that it's an HDR10 compatible display. We don't have too much HDR content available at the moment, but it's a bit of a future proofing on my end. The future, the more HDR content becomes available, I can take full advantage of this display simply because it supports it already. As a content creator, I also wanted to have an accurate sRGB or REC 709 output from my display. No worries here, the LG supports it and it has some pre-calibrated modes already included in the OCD. LG also claims that the 32UD99 supports a DCI-P3 coverage of around 95%. In reality, from what I read, it's only 90 to 91%, which is a bit disappointing. So the LG 32UD99 may not be the perfect display, but it ticked all my main boxes and covered all my needs, so I happily went with it. But hold on, I have to have a confession to make. This display isn't the one that I unpacked in the beginning of my video. The first display, when I unpacked it, I had a super close look at it simply because I wanted to review and I realized there is a lot of light bleeding coming from below and I had bit discoloration in the upper right corner. So I shot a photo of the display, I sent it to LG and asked them whether that is normal. They confirmed it's not and since I just bought it, I should return the display to the shop and get a new one. When I contacted the shop, the seller actually told me that this is consistent with all the other ones that he sold. And apparently this is, you know, known for this model, but he was kind enough to open two or three other ones to me, demonstrate the displays to me, and I could just pick the one that I liked the most. And indeed, when he showed me the first two other ones, they had pretty much the same issue. The third one, not too much of light bleeding, no discoloration, so I picked that one and now I'm super happy with my display. But I really don't know what to say because somehow it feels it's a bit of a lottery. You don't know whether you get a good version or a bad version. So do yourself a favor. If you buy it in the shop, ask the seller whether they could demonstrate the display to you. Pick the one that you really like the most, that you feel comfortable with, and you should be fine. Another issue I want to talk about, and that is the USB-C connection between the MacBook Pro and the display. Keep in mind, I use the USB-C cable that came with the display. Everything worked fine in the beginning, but somehow it seems every once in a while it loses the connection between the computer and the display. It's almost like, dip, the display is gone, and 1 second later it shows up again. It wouldn't be a huge deal, but as you guys know, once the external display is gone, all the open windows move onto the display of your MacBook Pro. Every time the display came back to life, I had to drag windows back and forth again, had to resize them in order to keep going with what I was, you know, just working on. It was super annoying. I don't know what the issue is, whether it's an issue with my MacBook Pro or with the display, but at one point I just gave up, threw the USB-C cable back to the box, Now I'm using the HDMI cable and everything works great. It's not a huge deal, it's not a deal breaker for me, but one of the reasons why I bought this display is that one single USB-C cable that connects your MacBook Pro with the display and at the same time charges it. Maybe it was too good to be true, it doesn't work. The HDMI cable is what powers this display now going forward. I have no problems at all anymore, but something that you should be aware of. Now, with this all being said, do I have any buyer's remorse? And the simple answer is no. Now that everything is being set up and I found a workaround for the issues that I had, first of all, I was able to pick the display that I liked the most. Second, I'm not too fussed about USB-C, so I'm getting by just fine with the HDMI cable. Now that everything is working fine, I simply love it. The overall look of the display, the stand, the thin bezels, the color, and how the design integrates with all the other stuff that I have on my display is just a joy to look at it. And most importantly, the image quality. Lots of real estate to work with, the colors are accurate and they're popping, it's sharp. As a daily driver, I couldn't ask for more. But I had a couple of issues that I explained earlier, so I think I gave you enough information so you can make up your mind yourself. And if you have similar issues like I had, I hope this video helps you to give you a bit of a direction as to how to deal with them. Now, if you still have any issues or you have any feedback or questions, as always, just leave a comment down below. Overall, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up because that helps me and that helps the channel grow. And as always, I catch you guys in my next video.